Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries, and in this video I want to give you an idea of what you can do with your cell phone while driving around on the Kubota compact tractor. I'm not sure if I'm the only one, but when I'm driving around on the Kubota I still like to keep my cell phone with me. So sometimes I put it in my pocket, but then I miss calls, and sometimes I put it in the holder of the drinking bottle. But yeah, that's also not a very optimal position. And then I just hope that it doesn't pop out. It hasn't until now, but you never know. So I was thinking about, hey, is there another option than that? So I looked around on the internet and I found this one. It's a bracket. The bracket is actually for a motorcycle. But yeah, if it can be used on a motorcycle, why not then also on a compact tractor? The bracket is completely aluminium. I think it was quite robust. Again, it's used for motorcycle holding. And it was about like 20 euros, so also for customs ideal. It will not be stopped. And in this video I will show you how I put this bracket, this cell phone bracket, onto this Kubota. So as you can see, it is meant for motorcycles, and I'm very curious if I can mount it properly to my Kubota tractor. So, well, when you can mount it on a motorbike, you can also mount it on a compact tractor. So, let's open the box. They're available in many colors. This one is, as you can see, in black. Because also my Kubota is black, at least around the steering wheel. So this is for mounting the cell phone. A manual. Here is for the mounting on the tractor. So sitting at my tractor, looking around where I could put in the cell phone holder, I think that maybe the mounting of the rear view mirror is a nice one, because then I can put it like here and touch it, and it's not in the way of any movement. So I think it's made for a steering bar of a motorcycle, so it's much too thin, so I need to increase the diameter of the tube in order to have a proper fit by quite some dimension. The minimum diameter of the mount is like 20 millimeters, 21. This is like 18 millimeters. So I really need to increase the diameter, and I will use some black tape for that to have that right diameter so I have enough clamping force. These are some protection strips. I think they need to put in here to protect it from scratching. So let's also do that. So as you can see, the conductivity tape is really moving sidewards. So it's not suitable for the filling of this mount, this bracket. So I need to find another solution for it in a rubber strip, something like that. I have to look for it. I'll find something. So the electrical insulation tape was not a success. It was too thick on the tube, and when you then try to press it, it moves aside, doesn't really work. So I found something else. This is what I use to tie young trees to prevent them from moving in the wind. But that's also some type of rubber strip that I can use. So I'm going to try that. Maybe that works better. Quite stiff material. So this is where you put in the cell phone. I put in the rubber strips. So now it also prevents damage. This part you can mount in two directions. You can mount it like this or like this. I mean, that's a choice you make. Now I decided to do it like this because then I have this hook. Don't know where to use it for at this moment, but at least it's then pointing upwards and I can hang something onto it. Don't know if it ever will be of any use, but yeah, we'll see. The rubber strip really worked to fixate it, and it's now quite well fixated towards the tube of the rearview mirror. So in the holder I already glued the strips to prevent scratching the cell phone, and you can also rotate it. So that's good, eh? So you can put it at any position, angle that you like. But I would like to also to block it, to fixate the angle when I have it in the right position. So I'm wondering what's behind the screen. So I'm going to take it off and to see if there's a way to fixate it. Maybe there's not, but there's only one way to find out. So I'm going to take out those screws. Okay, so this is how you change the angle. So I can take that out. There's a bolt at the back, so let's see if I unscrew it, what happens. Yeah, so the thread is in aluminium, you have to be a little bit careful because this can be easily destroyed. Taking it apart a little bit further, you can see there's a small spring inside. So that's why you can't really close it. So let's see how to deal with that. So I found this rubber ring and I'm going to put it in the middle. And perhaps that improves this effect. Let's see. So I now have the rubber ring in between, and that really makes the rotation much more stiff, which I like. I'm going to put in back the holding mechanism. So I now mounted the mobile phone bracket to the Kubota and I added two small parts of rubber in order to have a good fixation. One here because the tube was too small, and the other one over here because this makes it much more stable for rotating. So I can now mount the cell phone. So let's try. Already pre-adjusted it a little bit. So this is already quite good clamped. You can clamp it even more. Now it doesn't go anywhere. And I have an eye view from my seat onto the cell phone. Yeah. So it's now ready for a test. It's easy accessible. Works quite well. So now let's see if I
Nu is de speed a little bit and it becomes a little bit more bumpy, but it still keeps being fixed well. So far so good. So as you could see, I increased the speed a little bit to see if it still keeps fixed, and it works quite well. It's even on a bumpy ride, it doesn't fall off at all. It's well fixed, and the rubbers even give some damping, so I think that's also not a bad thing. So I think it's a good way to have a good fix of your cell phone, still having a good view on it, reachable, and still having a good connectivity.